Welcome, LEGO Star Wars fans, to the LEGO Star Wars review here on Booger Booger 9's channel. I'm your host, Booger Booger 9, and today, since it's a hot, sunny day in Florida in August, I thought I'd take a break from the heat and visit the planet of Hoth. So I'm hoping that you'll come with me as we check out an awesome LEGO Star Wars set from the icy planet of Hoth. So let's go ahead and check out this set. So did you guess right? There have been a lot of LEGO Star Wars sets from the planet of Hoth over the years, and this is one of them. It's one of the Hoth Echo Bases. And here's my information. Yes, it's set 7879. So I believe we have gotten one or two Echo Bases before, but this is my favorite for sure. So I'll go ahead and give you the rest of the particulars. I already told you it's set 7879. It comes with 773 pieces, but it looks bigger than that. And especially if you use one of the functions in the set, which I will show you, of course. And it retails for $89.99. A little high for price per piece, but not too worried about that here. And finally, the recommended age is 3 to 14, but as always, no one cares. No one. And if you do care, then go away, because I don't like you. No offense. So, we'll go ahead and get to the minifigures here in just a second. Can't really think of much else to say for preliminary thoughts other than I really like this set, so I'll probably rate it high. But before I can read it, I have to show it to you. So, I'm going to go ahead and do that right now. Alright, unfortunately we're going to have to go through this a little quickly because I'm running low on film. But I did want to try and show you the instruction booklets here really quickly. Nothing too important to see there. And you do get two of those. So I think it's a little thinner. And then of course on the back to show you some of the neat stuff that it does. But I need to go ahead and get to the minifigures because I don't want to have to carry this over to another tape. So, we will start with the stormtroopers. You do get two identical stormtroopers in this set. Do you see these in a lot of the Hoth sets? Do you like this nice little helmet slash backpack piece? That's very nice. Normal black head there. No back printing. And some fairly nice front printing there. And they do not come with any weapons or anything, but they do come with some brick build stuff, but we'll show you that after the rest of the minifigures. Here's our other snowtrooper. He is exactly the same. So, moving, we have Han Solo in Hoth attire. And this is the second time that we've seen him, and the second one that I have in Hoth attire. So he comes with this nice little hood here. A little bit nicer than the last one. And the blaster that he does come with in this set is a little smaller, but I don't have that in hand right now, so I just gave him that instead. He's kind of, looks like he's up to some mischievous something there. No back printing on either the head or the torso, but we do get some very nice printing on both the torso and the legs. So overall, a very nice minifigure, and it was one that I kind of had to include in this set. So, nice job on him. Next is Chewbacca. We all know Chewbacca because he comes in many a Star Wars sets. And this one, he does come with his, what is it called? Bowcaster. There we go. Bowcaster. So, a nice looking weapon there. You've all seen Chewbacca, I'm sure. That's the only fairly interesting piece on him. So, moving right along since we don't have that much time. Here is Luke Skywalker, and this is probably it's my favorite minifigure in the set. Definitely a very unique version of Luke here. This is after he's been attacked by the Wampa Ice creature, and he is in the Bacta tank in this scene. We'll show you that in a little bit, of course. So, some nice blondish hair here. And he does come with a double-sided face. So that's when he's still in the tank. And this is while he's recovering. So, yeah, this is my favorite minifigure in the set. So, very nice job on Luke there. Alright, so here's our next minifigure. It's Princess Leia in Hoth attire. So, nice job on this minifigure.
Got the nice hairpiece here. And the most interesting part about her is she comes with a popsicle. So a pretty unique piece there. I like that a lot. I thought there was a nice little humorous touch there. So there's that piece by itself. Moving right along, here is K-3PO. And you have to be a very careful observer to actually see him in the movie. But basically, it's a red C-3PO. So, fairly nice protocol droid here. This is actually my first protocol droid. I didn't get C-3PO until I got Droid Escape, and that was after I got this. And we'll be doing a review on that set soon. So it's K-3PO, and our final minifigure is, I want to say, B-19. Please let me know in the comments if I'm wrong. But I do know that this is the same droid that helped fix Anakin Skywalker into Darth Vader. So this is the nicest piece about him, is his torso piece right here. He's got all kinds of wire stuff all over him. So I like this minifigure a lot. And that's, I'm running out of time here, so we have him. We do have a Tauntaun in this set as well, which I'll show you now. So, very nice Tauntaun. This is the second Tauntaun I've got, and they're both the same. Right now he does have this tile piece in him to make it look like he's got nothing on him. Of course the horns come off as well, but I won't do that. And the arms move, but if you like, you can put the saddle in here instead of the tile piece. And you do also get these reins, which do fit in the mouth, but I'm not going to take the time to do that right now because I have a good time. Of course, he fits on the studs. You guys can see him in another review in a little more detail. So I'll be back in just a second to show you the rest of the sets fairly quickly. Alright, onto the set very quickly here. First of all, you get a snowtrooper cannon here. It is on the base here to give that snowy look. And we've got the cable there with a little box, ammunition box or whatever you want to call it. So you get that. And then we get the Hoth speeder bike, very similar to the Endor speeder bikes. In fact, I think it's exactly the same thing with different colored pieces. It's white instead of brown. With the bike's backpack on the back there. So if you want to see these in greater detail, watch one of the Endor ones. Because I want to get to the actual set and spend more time there. First of all, it opens up. So as a feature I was telling you about, to make it look even bigger, you can do it all the way out like this. So I'll show you what it looks like. Yes, that is Treebeard in the background. So, as you can see, it's quite massive like that. If it's not big enough for you at the beginning. So I guess I'll keep it like this and show you everything about it this way. This is probably like a heater or something, both of these things, to keep the Hoth echo base a little warmer. And of course, we get our cannons with our flick missiles. So I'll show you those now. So you get four flick missiles. One. You can move this way and this way. Two. This just came off. You get the idea. I have limited time. You know how a flick missile works, I know you do. Flipping around this way to show you this cannon here. That's not a flick missile cannon, but it does give a nice effect. It does spin 360. You can get past that piece right there. It does. Of course, there's a handle there. Moving on, we do get these signs with stickers on them. I don't know if any of you speak Star Wars languages. You can tell me what it says if you do. There's a little Tauntaun area. I got Han Solo there, and on the back, these things lock it in place, so you can't open it, but then if you move them out of the way, the gate comes down, and Han Solo can ride out to rescue Luke from the Wampa. you get some little icicle functions, which are pretty cool. You pull these out, and you get some icicles falling out. You do get another one of those, which I will show you. These boxes are on the top. They do fit on studs, but it's not in this case, because I have to do some modifying. And I'll go ahead and show you this part now. You can attach the boxes here. And move this. Alright, I'm going to set that to you from a different angle here. So, another nice little function there. So here's our other icicle function. You just pull this out, and those icicles will fall down. That was a nice little addition, I think. Get a satellite that, of course, swivels 360. Can't say I remember this from the movie, though. Maybe it was there. Yeah, I think I remember it now. So down here is our little mission area. These are stickers. Stickers on the other side. Sticker there. So it is a swivel to where I had Princess Leia sitting. Oh, and I forgot to show you that she does have a double-sided face. Sorry, I'm very forgetful when I'm rushed as I am right now. When film is running out, so she's angry there. You would want to see that. Moving right along. We get these. There should be blasters here, but I had to borrow them. And those move out for some reason. Not sure exactly why. And this is the best part about the set. You get the Bacta tank. And that does, of course, pull out. I like these little translucent blue pieces. Luke is in here. But we're going to say he's feeling better right now because we have to speed this along. And we'll fit him here. And hopefully he'll be feeling better soon. That does slip him. And that moves up and down too. And he just fell out, so I hope he's okay. Next, we have this part. And that does come off easily because it's just on four jumper plates. So you could pull that out if you wanted to. Basically up here we just get these things. Guardrails or whatever. Get these ladders. Of course that they can get up there easily, because sometimes Lego does not explain how many figures they're supposed to get from place to place very well. And I just broke that, of course. That's what happens when you're rushed. And I believe that's about all the main stuff. I haven't got the warning signal yet, so we'll give you a bit of a 360. We'll just say that an AT-AT has just attacked, and that's why I fell over. You get some fairly large burps here, big ugly rock pieces if you didn't know what that stands for. So I thought that some of you might want to see that. Let me put this back together here and I'll show it to you one more time. Alright, so here's a last look at the set. Sorry I had to kind of rush through this a little bit. You know what? I haven't got the warning signal yet. And I know that you all want to see this. So I'm gonna go ahead and flick these last two missiles. There we go. Hopefully I made some of you happy. Anyway, if there's anything that I did not cover that I forgot to, then just post in the comments any questions that you have and I will answer them either in text or video format, depending on what the question is. I believe this set is still on the LEGO webpage, but I'm not positive about that. So I am getting the 5-minute warning signal here. So you can take a look at that for a few more minutes while I give you a few little building tips. So these are both from this set, but I did want to show you what this looks like open. With a snow speeder inside. This is from the Hoth Wampa Cave. Definitely pick that set up if you still can. Zev Sneska in there. We'll be doing that set soon. So I'll just hold out for that. So as you can see, it looks very nice with some StarCraft in there. Kind of completes the look. And I didn't bring all of my other Hoth sets out. I do have a few more. But you'll just want some generic troopers. I got these from a smaller Hoth that isn't available anymore. I forget what it is called. Of course, some more snow troopers. There's R2-D2. Because we all have quite a few of him. He's kind of like Chewbacca in that way. And got another Tauntaun here from that same set. I will see what the name of that set is, but I can't remember it off the top of my head. So, definitely pick up some more Hoth sets. I know that one of the more recent ones is called the Battle of Hoth, and I do not have that one. Because frankly, I don't feel like I need it. Because most of the stuff that's in there I already have, like snow speeders, Tauntauns. Really the only reason I would get it is for the probe droid, which is pretty cool. And I don't have that. So, on to the ratings. For the build, for unique pieces, of course, get the Tauntaun mold, which is pretty cool. Get some of these bigger satellite dishes. Some of these clear pieces right here, don't see too often. Of course, these, I love these pieces. You get two of those, the clear blue cylindrical pieces. Of course, you get a couple of burps back here. Yeah, that is about it for unique pieces. That is, of course, that's not in the set. Oh, and the popsicle. I love the popsicle that Princess Leia has there. That is pretty cool. And that's the only time I've ever seen that, actually, in set form. So for the build, it was a fun build. So I will give it an 8. An 8 for the build. For the playability, you get the falling icicles, which are a little bit hard to put back, but they're fun to unleash. Get this little weapons rack, which folds back here, if I can do that. Yes, I can. Get these swinging boxes. I had to borrow those boxes so they do not have the cargo stickers on them. Of course, this octatank opens. Get this little chair here, swivel chair here. 4 foot missiles over there. The opening Tauntaun gate over here. So for the playability, I'm going to give this a 9. Yes, a 9. And if you get some other sets like the Hoth Wampa Cave, the Battle of Hoth, especially an AT-AT, I do not have one of those, unfortunately. Would like to get my hands on one of those one day, but it might be too late because I'm sure those are going to go up in price, especially the motorized ones. So, for the playability, I give that a 9, but if you get some of the other sets, it's a 10. Because who doesn't like Hoth? Even if you're not a big Star Wars fan, I think everybody has a little bit of an affection for Hoth. Because it's one of the more interesting planets. And finally, for the displayability. It looks very nice. Don't get an outside shell or whatever. But, if you did do that, it would be very large. You'd almost have to make that non-minifigure scale. And of course, they like to make things minifigure scale for LEGO Star Wars. It's not LEGO architecture. So, yeah, it's going to be a 9 for display, I think. If you get some of the other sets, it's a 10. So this has been another Bilbo Bricko 9 review. Thanks for watching. And make sure you check out especially some of the other Hoth reviews.